today. From Lambeau Field in Green Bay, Wisconsin. This is Madden Football on EA Sports. We'll see Aaron Rodgers and the Green Bay Packers taking on Tom Brady and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
We are at the oldest continually operating stadium in the NFL as you're going to look inside Lambeau Field in Green Bay, Wisconsin. No team means more to a city than the Packers to Green Bay, and this was the scene a few moments ago as the green and gold made their way out of the historic tunnel. They're ready to go as they get set to match up with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. The punter Bradley Pinion on to get us started, and off we go from Lambeau. Rodgers on the return, and they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30. Here we go with the Packer offense, guided by their decorated QB with a long list of Pro Bowls and other accolades next to his name, of course. Aaron Rodgers leading the way.
I remember watching him in college and seeing a guy that you knew had great potential, but I don't know that anyone knew that we would see how he would blossom as an NFL player who will go down as one of the all-time great quarterbacks. Can make every throw from every angle with terrific mobility, and he knows how to win games, always in contention for a championship.
On first and 10, here's Rodgers. Got an open man. It's Valdez Scantling. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
And I think this is a route we'll see more of as this game goes on, because with his speed, they want to get him the ball in space on drag routes just like this. They want him to get the ball and run after the catch. Good job there, though, holding him for a short gain.
Now the man from UTEP. This is Aaron Jones.
I think that's the type of run we'll continue to see throughout this game. The snow coming down, I don't expect a lot of big plays to be broken.
Rodgers now on first down. Dancing to his left. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
Down, Rodgers. Out of the backfield, this is Aaron Jones. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere, and they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well, and that's what they just did on that play.
Now a first down carry by Jones. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly. And that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. They'll run with a big back, A.J. Dillon. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. This will be a loss of three, and now a much tougher third down looming.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
And the box with an extra defender in the secondary now on third down. Here's Rodgers to throw. Setting up the screen here, Aaron Jones. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. They'll wind up losing three here on the play. And that's going to make it fourth down. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area, that they want him involved. Just as you said, they want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
On fourth down, on is Corey Bohorquez to punt. And this will be out of bounds. Now it's a question of where they'll mark it. And they'll say it crosses at the 11-yard line. First try on offense for the Bucs and their veteran quarterback, Tom Brady.
Well, we've all seen what Tom Brady can do on a football field for a couple of decades now. But how about his most impressive accomplishment? Moving to a different franchise and taking them to a Super Bowl title as well. Not many players can continually stiff-arm Father Time the way that he has.
Brady going to bring the Bucs up with a first and 10 at their own 11. Throwing to start the drive. Brady. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in.
There is something to a game plan with trying to keep a defense honest with a guy with that type of speed. You do so. Send him deep. Try to throw some air under it and hope you connect downfield. On that play, they were unsuccessful.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Here's Brady to throw. Looking for Gronkowski, and it's intercepted. Devondre Campbell, the linebacker, picks him. And into the end zone. It's a pick six and a Packer touchdown. So a dangerous pass over the middle into zone coverage, and it bit him hard.
And what's really difficult when you throw it in that direction and versus that zone, that means the linebackers have gotten to their spot, gotten their heads back around, and they can see the quarterback and everything in front of them. And they took big advantage of it, went the other direction, excellent blocking, and picked up a touchdown.
On is Mason Crosby for the point after. Boy, these may be an adventure this afternoon, but this one is good. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. Fielded just outside the goal line. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. Tom Brady leads the offense out for their next possession. And looking to erase his memory bank from his opening drive a moment ago that ended in a pick six for the first points of the ball game.
And in my experience, a lot of quarterbacks, after throwing a pick six, the first thing they want to do is fire another one and get those points back. immediately, but what really helps you get back in sync is a good, long, methodical drive, mixing the run and the pass, tamp things down a little bit.
Brady and the Buccaneers here, first and 10 at their own 27. Brady's throw taken in by Evans here. And some room to maneuver. And they do finally get him, but he takes it to the 25. A big play that time for Tampa Bay.
We know play callers can be very creative in this game today, but sometimes when they've got receivers with speed like this, they don't need to design incredibly complex calls. Sometimes it's just get the ball in his hands and let him do his thing. In a sense, less can become more, and it was right there.
Brady now on first down. And his pass incomplete.
And I can see the officials kind of looking at each other down there, silently wondering, does this meet the level of grounding? Fortunately, he did have a receiver in the area, but I have seen less obvious throwaways called as penalties.
Second and 10. Now Brady. It's complete. It's Miller. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6. On third down, they had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. Brady down throw. And this is caught at the 8. And the Buccaneers are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
A very important third down conversion right there, because when you're trailing and find yourself this deep in enemy territory, the kicker's not even part of your thought process. You got to make it pay off with 6. Nice connection right there to set up first and goal.
So first and goal and a chance to make amends for the earlier pick 6. They'll try and run for it with Fournette. And a nice pick up there. He gets about 5 down to the 4-yard line. So that run gets him about halfway home.
Yeah, it's now second and goal. The end zone beckons. It looms. They can do whatever they want. Full playbook. Run it again, or they can go play action and try and put it in that way.
Second and goal from inside the 5. Fournette again. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Leonard Fournette taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Buccaneers are an extra point away from tying up this football game. So it was the passing game that got him down here, but closer to the goal line, it's the running game that gets him home.
Certainly appears that they lulled the defense into thinking that the passing game was going to be it the entire drive. Nice change up there going to the running game to get him over the goal line.
Ryan Succop on for the point after. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. The drive will start at the 25-yard line here as Rodgers will not return it. The Packers offense here coming back out for their second drive. and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
Rodgers will break the huddle and bring the pack up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Throwing to start the drive. Rodgers. And this one almost intercepted. Not a good throw there. Nearly an opening drive, INT.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
So the incompletion, and now it's second and 10, again from the 25-yard line. Shotgun now for Rodgers. And this is caught. Mercedes Lewis with a grab. And he's upended at the 33, following a good pickup of 8.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Rodgers looking to throw on third and 2. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up.
That's what you're going to need to do against those big receivers. You got to get in there and get physical with them. That time he got in close, got in tight, and knocked the ball away.
On now is the Packers punter as he'll kick it away for the second time. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt, and the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. So out come the Bucs now. The last possession, these guys were able to tie the game with a touchdown, and now they'll have a chance to move out in front.
Yeah, let's give a big assist to the defense who got the ball back. The special teams went out there, handled things. They've got it. They've got momentum. I know they're eager to get out there and put it on display.
Brady and the Bucs now with a first and 10 at the 34. Now he'll begin with a give to Fournette to start the drive. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Now Brady. Dumps it off to Fournette. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. So 8 yards on the completion there. And that'll bring up a 3rd and 1. This up to the 46, good enough for the first.
Brandon, what were they thinking on defense there? That looked like they were playing for the pass. That was 3rd and short. Yeah, it was an easy pickup because they handed it to him. That was way too easy.
Just looked like absolute confusion defensively. Not sure why they were in that set.
Yeah, I'd say you ought to have a few men in the box there.
This one down to the 40-yard line. Consecutive plays now where that offensive line has really created a lot of space.
And we've seen the confidence rise, haven't we? It borders on arrogance now, and that's that good arrogance, believing you can run the football whenever you get good and ready.
So into Packer territory now. Here's first and 10, right at the 40. Here's Brady. And his throw is incomplete.
Well, the gap man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Brady going to throw. Over the middle, complete. It's Miller. Flashed the stick skills, but didn't get a ton from it. Stopped short of the 35. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes when they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air, and sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there is they were able to connect.
The one with the dive look that time on defense just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
So Brady departs, and on it's Ryan Suckup for the Buccaneer field goal. From the left hash, this from 53 yards out. And that is no good. He gave it a good run. That wasn't more than a foot or so wide to the left. And in this first quarter of play, this will remain a tie ball game. Green Bay offense ready to take over. They've had it twice. They punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all. And let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice. So they're furiously going over things on the sidelines. What do we need to do to pick up a first down and change our momentum?
So the long field goal misses, and now the reverse. You're in a tough spot defensively. They'll start the drive at the 43. Now a throw over the middle, and he's got it to start the drive. A gain of 6 there on first. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger gain. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
From just shy of midfield, Rodgers, he gets this to Devontae Adams. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field, and here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
So from Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10, down at the 31. Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. And he'll get about 3 as he's brought down to the 28.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out. And they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
A 2nd and 7 with our score tied at 7. But they're planning to change that soon. Only question, will they get 3 or 6 out of it? Meanwhile, Rodgers' throw taken in by Adams. These two teams all tied after 1. first down. Jones. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. And even 20 yards for Aaron Jones. And the Packers have taken the lead.
Well, partner, that was another explosive run. And one thing I've learned in our time in this game, yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit, but for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball too, right?
Oh, without a doubt. You need that difference maker lugging the rock.
Now Crosby for the point after. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. Play in the drive was a touchdown run by Aaron Jones. For the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he'll wind up getting a couple extra yards here for his trouble and bringing it out of the end zone as he's down at the 27. Leonard Fournette making his way back out there. And for him, it's been pretty limited involvement down on the scoreboard. Maybe time to turn to this guy.
And you know me well. Winning games to me means starting with the running game and continuing to press the running game. Maybe you go away from him a little bit now, but the bottom line is he hasn't touched it enough to make a difference.
Well, they haven't established that running game yet. The question is, will they? Brady going to bring the Bucs up with a first and 10 at their own 27. Throwing to start the drive. Brady. And that was going to be off target and incomplete.
I would say it'd probably be a good idea for him to reintroduce himself to his receivers at the half because they're definitely on different wavelengths. But I also don't advocate waiting that long. Next series before you get out there. Hey, let's get together, guys. Let's get this thing moving.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Now Brady. He gets this one to Johnson. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and 3.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone, and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
Again, it's Johnson. And he is going to have a Bucs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
That's a play that'll likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
Again, they'll throw with Brady. And his throw here's incomplete. He shook his head right when he released that throw. He knew it was going to be a little off target.
Yeah, the excitement got him on that one. Wasn't able to control the fact the receiver was open, and it would have been an easy throw.
So second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43. Throwing now is Brady. And he finds Howard complete. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and 1.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about 3 different routes, and that was it. Now you can run anything and catch the ball, as we just saw there.
The Bucs on third down. just a yard here. It's third and one. They'll try and run for it with Fournette. And able to pick up the first across midfield to the 47.
They had yet to run the ball at all on this drive, but third and short, definitely was a great time to dial one up.
Fakes the give to Fournette. Now Brady. Now he's going to go up top over the middle. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Adrian Amos with a pick. And the Packers are going to take possession here at their own 16-yard line. You don't see this often, a quarterback of his caliber, two first-half interceptions.
It's absolutely surprising because it happens so rarely. You're searching for what reason, what's going on out there. It's not just maybe the defense is playing well. Is his horoscope off? His biorhythms? What is it?
You went horoscope on us, David.
Well, I was thinking maybe REM sleep was off. I'm trying to come up with something.
Anything, right?
Rodgers will bring the pack up with a first and 10 at their own 16. And he'll begin the drive with a give to Jones. And he'll take this one up to about the 23. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Working with a second and 4. Here's a give to Jones running left. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. 45 yards rushing for him now on just 6 carries to this point.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower his center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
After the run by Jones, here's first and 10. Working from the gun, Rodgers. Oh, the Buccaneer pressure too much. Down he goes. Shaquille Barrett put that sack by his name in the stat sheet.
I thought there at the end he may have had a chance to release that, but that pocket closed a little too quickly and down he went.
Yeah, he was certainly trying to do everything he could to extend the life of the play, probably counting in his head, 1, 2, and then he ran out of time.
After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. To throw is Rodgers. To Valdez-Scantling over the middle. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. Here's Rodgers. Another catch for Valdez-Scantling. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. They stop him for only 3 that time, and that'll bring up fourth down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet. Get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. A solid punt, but also a nice return there of 14 yards. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. The Buccaneers getting ready to go as they take the field. And two picks thrown here in this first half alone. We'll see how that affects him.
Can't wait to see where his confidence is, because the great ones, they'll throw four or five picks, and while it'll hurt their team, it won't hurt their confidence. They'll think something was just wrong with the ball or the wind or something was funny. It's never about them. That's how they stay so into the moment and into the game.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. They'll drop this off for Bernard. That catch good for only a couple.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
Second down and 8. Brady. And he finds Gronk. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
The Bucs on third down. They've been near perfect. 4 for 5 to this point. This will be 3rd and 5. To throw, it's Brady. Completing it to the right side, Johnson. And he goes out of bounds and looks like right at the 50.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out to the sideline and make a catch.
Fournette, a first down carry. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be 2nd down.
Even though they gave up more than they wanted to on that play, it actually illustrates how well they bottled him up throughout the game, because that was his longest run of this contest.
5 yards remain on 2nd down. To throw is Brady. It's caught. It's Miller. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers 30.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there, because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
So 1st and 10 now from the 30. Working from the gun, it's Brady. He's got it complete to Gronkowski. Heck of a broken tackle and able to work this down near the 23. 7 yards, the pick up there.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. They fake the handoff. Now Brady. Over the middle to Evans. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And a little bit of space there takes it inside the 5 to the 3. Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break.
So the ball position now at the three. Here's second and goal. Fournette. And he's in. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Leonard Fournette with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Buccaneers are an extra point away from tying up this football game.
So, CD, there didn't seem to be much resistance there down near the goal line.
Yeah, partner, from what I saw there, not a real good job of matching up defensively, because to me, they look like they were just in their base 3-4 package. You need bigger bodies in there in a goal line type situation. The 3-4, fine between the 20s, but not down here when you're guarding your end zone.
Suck up for the extra point. And we've got a good one brewing. We're all knotted up at 14. That time, a 9-play drive. And the man who finished it off with a run into the end zone, Leonard Fournette. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. Rodgers on the return. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Another drive coming up for this Packers offense. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, do you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a 2nd and 3, 2nd and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks, because then the defense has the advantage.
Rodgers will break the huddle and bring the pack up 1st and 10 at their own 26. Throwing to start the drive. Rodgers. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. 2nd and right at a yard.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
From the 35 on 2nd down, Rodgers. Right side, it's Lewis.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to 1.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on 1st down. A give to Jones. Levante David in on the tackle.
We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done, because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
On 2nd and 9, Rodgers. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's 3rd down.
Have to give some credit to the defender on that when he read all of his keys perfectly and got a great break on the ball and able to force that incompletion.
The Packers on 3rd down, 0-for-3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This is 3rd and 9. Rodgers going to throw. Caught on the right side by Jones. And this one's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42. On now is the Packers punter, as he'll punt it away for the 4th time today. And this one hits at the 3 and then bounds into the end zone for a touchback. Leonard Fournette and the rest of the Bucs offense set to take over once more.
And he's found the end zone twice, and now I'm guessing he's thinking, hey, let's find it three times.
And you got to figure from the defensive perspective, how has he gotten there twice? What are we going to do to keep him out for a third time? How do we tighten things down? Because he and his offensive mates, they're really in sync right now.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
In this weather, any big play in the passing game, that's just a bonus, right?
It certainly is, but oftentimes offenses think inclement weather plays to their advantage because you know where you're going on offense. Defenders have to react, and they often slip.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Operating from the gun, Brady. He finds his tight end, Howard. That's complete. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
First down now, but that clock rolling. From the gun, it's Brady. That's complete to his running back, Evans. And he's going to get this inside the 30.
My goodness, they've come out locked in on this drive. Play calling, execution, they're fully in sync. Three straight passes, three first downs. They're moving the ball downfield almost at will. This defense really struggling to find answers.
Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. Brady now on first down. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Miller. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Into the red zone, it's Brady. Finding Miller once more, complete. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. So five plays on this drive, Charles, all passes, all completions, and just like that, they're in the red zone.
And don't you think the playbook opens up a little bit more now? Because all they've done is throw the football. If you want to run it now, you may very well have them fooled.
Second down at 5. Brady to throw again. Quick completion here to Johnson. And the Bucs are going to be set up with a first and goal on a pass play that moves him all the way down to the 1.
And with that completion, he's now north of 200 yards here in the first half. Boy, a tough start for the secondary defensively.
It is, and it's got to put a dent in their confidence. And, you know, you always want to keep that up and feel like you can always bounce back after plays. But with the kind of numbers he's putting up here, it's starting to wear on them a little bit, I think. So they're looking at each other and trying to figure out what defense will work and how can they play better without getting beat deep for big passes.
Here's Brady to throw. And Evans calls it in. Touchdown, Bucs. Mike Evans, as the first half is winding down. And the Buccaneers have taken the lead here in the final stages of this first half.
So that really an almost perfect drive as they chew up some clock and wind up scoring late in this first half.
And remember, they've got a chance to double dip here because they're going to get the ball first to start the third quarter. So they potentially could go up two scores before the other guys get a chance to do anything.
Extra point try now for Suckup. It's up and good, and that'll make the score 21-14. So that a 7-play, 80-yard drive. And it's all finished off with a touchdown by Tampa Bay. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Rodgers on the return. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. Set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line as they take over here with 11 seconds remaining. Complete. This is Lewis. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number two. Shot before half for Rodgers. And this is incomplete with a clock showing just 3 seconds left.
That is the first time that they've targeted him that he has not come down with a catch.
He's caught everything that's been thrown his way. A dominant pass receiver that can break down any defense, because when he's doing that kind of work, it really hurts you on the back end.
And even though it's an incompletion there, I think they're going back to that well. They'll get this one into the hands of Lewis. And he is going to have a Packers first down. They needed 4. He doubled that. He wound up getting 8. So we have reached halftime here with the visiting Buccaneers out on top. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to an abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everybody, to our abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. The snow certainly making conditions difficult, and it's not likely to get better anytime soon, as we turn it right back over to Brandon and Charles.
All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. Has changed since we left you at halftime. The snow still continuing to fall as we are back underway. This one fielded at the 5. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. Out come the Buccaneers. They'll have it first to start the third quarter. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half they didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it, but I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities, and I will guarantee you that those guys were lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime.
Well, this has been all that we'd hoped for. Two of the game's all-time great QBs slugging it out in a one-score game here in the second half. First and 10. Meanwhile, Brady's throw taken in by Evans here.
And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just going to ask you, that wasn't the primary target, and he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, ah, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
On play action, it's Brady. This is caught by Evans. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40.
I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them. And these guys have been taking advantage so far.
So into Packer territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 42-yard line. Here's a give to Fournette. Dancing away at the 35. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Shotgun now for Brady. And Miller with it over the middle. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. Whatever the discussions were at halftime to try to slow down this offense, it has not worked to this point.
Yeah, I have a vision right now of everything that was discussed at the half just being torn in shreds or being erased off of the Microsoft Surface tablets because none of it is working. They are really locked in on offense.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. Throwing into traffic there, and that's complete. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed, because you hit a guy on the run like that, you often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. They go back to the ground now with Fournette. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Leonard Fournette, a 5-yard touchdown run. And the Buccaneers take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. That seemed pretty ideal there for the offense, Charles. You take a little bit of time off the clock here in the third quarter, decent length drive, and you pad your lead as well at the end of it.
And what it does is let you feel like you're in control of this game, even more so than a 2-touchdown lead, right? Because you've taken that time off, as you noted, which means they couldn't get you off the field. You ran your playbook the way you wanted to, and you gave your defense some rest. What a big-time drive in that situation.
You always worry about the plant foot in the snow, but no problems there. And the lead now up to 14.
Now Pinion with a kickoff honors following the touchdown. Rodgers going to return it from his end zone. And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line, so the same result had he opted for the touchback. Here's the Packers offense now getting set to start off this third quarter. And their deficit a little wider than it was at halftime. Does that touchdown a minute ago change the thinking here at all?
I think it does, at least a little bit, because now urgency has to start setting in. You can't go out there and go three and out and run the risk of falling behind substantially, but you have to do it without pressing, because pressing, that'll lead you into bigger errors.
Rodgers will bring the pack up with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Throwing to start the drive, Rodgers, and he fires one that's intercepted. Picked up by Jordan Whitehead, and it's a pick six. He brings it back to the house for a Buccaneer TD. Well, dare I say it, it's kind of quid pro quo. Both defenses now with an interception return for a touchdown.
Your vocabulary, sir. Well done.
Suck up for the extra point. And he's been a busy man. 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. The drive will start at the 25-yard line here as Rodgers will not return it. The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here. And fresh off the pick six, they've got to forget about that quickly.
In this case now, the guy throwing the ball, he's got to be like what we talk about with defensive backs who get beat for a long touchdown. Short-term memory, right back out there doing the things that he does best, and knowing that taking care of the ball is paramount, here's his opportunity.
It all comes back to those defensive backs for the former DB, right?
I don't know where that comes from. It just kind of emerges out of me for some reason.
It's deep in there, right? And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
Second down, another shot for Jones. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. The give is to Jones. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
Now they'll throw with Rodgers. Over the middle, that's caught by Adams. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
So from Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10 at the 48-yard line. Now Rodgers. Flushed out right. And he works his way past the line of scrimmage and then slides to a halt. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there at second down.
Now how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
Second down at 7. Shotgun now for Rodgers. That's taken in by the tight end, Josiah DeGuara.
And the tight end is certainly a position built to move the chains because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then of course they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is they're right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play. And that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
They'll run on first down. It's Jones. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
You got to figure the further they fall behind, the more you think that they'll get away from the run. They're trying to stick with it, but the results, they just aren't there.
Behind the chain, second and 12. Throwing is Rodgers. This one swung out here to Jones. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. So they'll wind up losing 5 yards on the play. And they're going to be staring at a third and long here.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
A long way to go here on third down for the 8th play of the drive. Shotgun now for Rodgers. He hits Adams, complete. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs' 15-yard line.
That's a big gainer on that play. And from experience, I can tell you, that's where defensive backs will come into the huddle and say, guys, how about some pass rush? But you're going to say it nicely because those big guys up front, they don't like being criticized very much. Quarterbacks in this league, you know they'll pick you apart if you give them time like that to find receivers downfield.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Into the red zone. It's Rodgers. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Lewis. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line.
And I'll tell you what, this offense is playing a little bit of keep away right now. They've come out here in the third quarter, possessed the ball for quite a while, and they keep on converting. Nice pitch and catch there to set up the first and goal.
So the false start will back them up 5.
False start for offense.
And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves them back 5. Try again here, first and goal after the false start. After the penalty, it's Jones. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Only a yard on the pickup there, second and goal.
Every team we ever talk to that continues to run the ball in a game, even when they haven't had much success, all talks about attrition, don't they? If you keep running it, eventually good things are likely to happen.
It's been a hard go in this game today, hasn't it?
Yeah, this defense, they met pretty much every challenge in front of them this afternoon.
They're still trying to run the ball, but they're not finding much space.
Toward the pylon, caught. Touchdown. Mercedes Lewis from 6 yards away. And the Packers get a score closer.
This is why a lot of play callers love play action in this spot. You just want to freeze the linebackers just for a second. Then you got a chance to get a quick pass into your tight end right behind them for a touchdown.
Extra point try now for Crosby. Cut down to 14. That one in the books as a 12-play drive. And it ends with a Packers touchdown. After the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. Taking it about the one. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Mike Evans and the Tampa offense about to set up shop.
And I know that they've double-teamed him a couple times, but not a ton. Whatever they're doing isn't working. He's up over 100 yards. We'll see how they adjust.
And when they do that, they weaken their defense in other places as well. And how many times have we done games where we've seen a guy have a big game like this? But it's usually not by himself, is it?
Right.
Usually it opens it up for other people to have big games as well.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. Their lead down from 21 to 14, but still sitting in a great spot. Up two scores here in the third quarter.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Tackle made by Devondre Campbell.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Brady now to throw. Oh, that'll be incomplete. Well, he took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out here and get the football right back, because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side. And all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
Throwing is Brady on third down. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free. And it brings up fourth down.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started. And that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
Here's Bradley Pinion now. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed till here in the third. And here's Rodgers on the return. They'll get 9 yards on the return there following a punt of 42. And it'll be Packer football here, first down and 10. Now Aaron Rodgers and the offense heading back onto the field. Last series, the ball never hit the ground. 6 of 6, touchdown pass, so whatever he did then, do it again, right?
Yeah, it reminds me a lot of when I watched the best quarterbacks throw 7-on-7, or even routes versus air. They're accurate, the receivers catch it, the ball never touches the ground. Or if you want to take it to basketball, a well-executed fast break, right? Pass, 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 finish at the rim, basket. Yeah, ball never hits the ground there either.
Play action. Now it's Rodgers. Got an open man. It's Valdez Scantling. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. They were in zone defensively. Went with a crossing route.
It's always interesting to watch that chess match.
Yeah, and I think safeties don't mind crossing routes against zone, because eventually you're going to run into their territory, and that's when they lick their chops in order to get the big hit or a play on the ball.
Offensively, nice execution to find a hole, make the catch. And just a yard to go here on second down. Working from the gun, Rodgers. That's into a crowd and intercepted. It's Devin White, the linebacker. And it's a pick six. He brings it back to the house for a Buccaneer TD. This D wanting to put it away before we even get to the fourth quarter, widening that margin a bit further.
And while they won't just empty the bench just yet, if you're a backup, start loosening up. I think you'll get a chance to play before this one is over now with that type of a cushion.
Extra point try now for Succop. And the lead now to three touchdowns and 21 points. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. This fielded right at the goal line. Here's Aaron Jones in the offense trotting back out. So after that hot start, the numbers here show the decline. What has the defense done adjustment-wise?
Sometimes when you have a running back who's gotten off to a hot start, you've got to catch him before he really gets going. So you change what you do across the defensive front. Instead of the linebackers being back a few yards, you bring them up closer. It's what we call mugging the line of scrimmage, taking away a lot of blocking angles and gaps, and maybe stopping him before he can get going.
Mugging the line of scrimmage, okay.
Yeah, in this case,
the Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They'll try and get the running game going with Jones. William Golston in on the stop.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
Run got three. Now here's second and seven. Again, it's Jones. Call it a gain of five there on the run, but they'll remain a yard or two short here with third down coming up.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Packers on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. Here it's third and two. Now Rodgers. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41.
Looks to me, partner, like he's learned a little bit
because earlier in the game, I think he was trying to force a lot of throws into his windows that just weren't open.
Yeah, the interceptions had plagued him, especially a second interception, really a bad throw. So maybe a better decision there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I think he learned from earlier in the game, and he's applying it now.
I'll tell you, far from ideal conditions to play in, but neither offense has had much trouble. Plenty of points to go around. First and 10. And this throw a bit late as he couldn't reach back for it. But defensively, you look at the numbers. Another incomplete pass that we just saw, and they're under 200 yards passing for the game, so they've done their job on that side of the ball.
Yeah, recently I was actually working a game where a quarterback had a streak of five straight games without a 200-yard game. And that was a big talk, both in his town and amongst his team. How do we get the passing game going? So big credit to them, holding them under 200 today.
They get six. That'll leave them with third and four. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give them that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
The Packers on third down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. This is third and four. To throw, it's Rodgers. He's got his man, Valdez-Scantling. Touchdown, Packers! Marquez Valdez-Scantling, 53 yards. And the Packers have got it back to a two-score game here in the fourth. And nothing too crazy there. A quick slant, and then he just had a seam. He found a seam.
And when you hit it on the run like that, and I mean the pass right to the receiver who's already in motion and moving, sometimes he just takes it and runs away from everyone else.
And he ran it into the end zone. And the defense, they've got to adjust there quickly. That's tough on them.
That's really tough because everything was executed well. Ball was out of his hands quickly, into the hands of the receiver, and then he was gone.
Crosby connects on the extra point, and the lead will be cut down to 14. A drive that time of 6 plays, and the result, a Green Bay score. For the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. This taken in at the goal line. And he takes this near the 25, just a little pass there, call it the 26. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. Well, there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
Brady and the Buccaneers here, first and 10 at their own 26. Throwing to start the drive, Brady. Toward the right sideline, but it's incomplete. Got out of the pocket. Didn't look like he had anybody open, Charles, so just gets rid of it.
And a good play by him. If no one's open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take, make the right choice. Get rid of it. Live to fight another down.
Here's second and 10. Fournette running out of the gun. And he's going to get about 7 yards on that one, up to around the 33.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter,
you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. The Bucs on third down. They've been very good, 5 for 7 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 3. Now Brady. It's complete. It's Miller. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. Good defense holds him to only a yard, and it'll be 4th down.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route, and he ran a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line, but once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
Here's Bradley Pinion now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. On the return, it's Rodgers. So holding there on the return, and that'll back him up to start the next drive.
Yeah, that's a pretty easy call right there, partner. I think when the officials look in their manual and see the expression, jersey getting pulled, that's a flag coming out every time.
The holding penalty and negates a good return as they'll start just past the 20. On first down, Rodgers. Setting up the screen here, Aaron Jones. 7 yards there on the first down screen play. Fourth quarter, every drive so critical, and you figure may only get one more shot after this, so a touchdown's imperative on this drive.
It is, but you also have to think to yourself in play calling, don't hold anything back. Don't save it for the second touchdown. You've got the first one for the second one to even matter.
From the 29, Rodgers. It's caught here by Adams. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35.
Good yardage on the completion there. When they look at the scoreboard, they do understand a field goal is not going to do them any good. My guess, they're going to press the ball downfield as far as possible, try and throw it into the end zone and get a score because they know they've got to get that done and get the ball back as quickly as possible.
Rodgers now on first down. Flush to his right.
As a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
Midfield, here's Rodgers. Open man right side is St. Brown. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field, and now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
The 32 now. Here's 1st and 10. Now Rodgers. Looking sideline, incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
An incomplete pass on 1st down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. To throw is Rodgers.
Open man, here is Cobb. And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Caught on the right side by Adams. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of stop him. Why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
On second down, it's Jones. And a short pickup there down to about the 9. Calling a gain of a yard, and it's going to bring up 3rd and 5.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
They'll break the huddle and come up on the 9th play of this drive, needing 5 yards on 3rd down. From the gun, it's Rodgers. And this is going to be incomplete.
And when you've thrown as many interceptions as he has in this one, you definitely start getting a little hesitant to throw the ball out wide because that's prime pick six territory. That time, he made sure the only guy who was going to catch it was sitting in the 3rd row.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on 4th down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. The quick slant caught. And the Packers are going to have 1st and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. 4th down, trailing in the 4th quarter. They felt compelled to go for it, and they got it.
Well, I'd look down at my play sheet, and what I would find, plays have been successful throughout the game that have worked in the distance you need, and that's exactly what they got done.
Now it's Rodgers. And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground. Down this close to the goal line, 1st down. Surprised that wasn't a run?
I am, and you know I'm old school. I want to run the ball 1st down in this situation because 2nd down, that gives me an option of running play action and maybe throwing it.
Another shot from the 1 on 2nd and goal. They're going to go with a tight end here on the running play. And he'll take this one in for a Packer touchdown. Mercedes Lewis, a beast in the red zone with his 2nd touchdown of the game. And the Packers have made it a 1-score game again here in the 4th. So very late in the game here, but with that score, some light at the end of the tunnel.
There's still hope. Now they look at the score and say, hold on a second. This thing's not over yet. Let's keep battling.
For the point after. And that'll cut the lead down now to a touchdown. So that drive spans 13 plays, and it ends with a 1-yard touchdown run. After the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. Here comes the Tampa Bay offense now heading back out onto the field. This game has really flipped on its head. 2 unanswered touchdowns by the other side, and now... yeah, they take over here with just a very slim 1-score lead.
And we've seen this how many times now?
teams get a big lead, they go into coast mode, and all of a sudden they're scrambling and battling for a win down the stretch. They've got to put something together right here, otherwise they're in danger of doing the old snatching defeat from the jaws of victory.
On first and 10, here's Brady. Throw left side complete. That's Howard. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect him to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
To throw again on second down. Brady, slant route to Miller. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled.
Well, that should be a reminder defensively, and I think it's a reminder to myself because you just can't sell out to stop the run. There's still enough time that this offense can move the football through the air, even on first and second downs, and they obviously picked the right spot to throw the ball there.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. To throw, it's Brady. Wide open, Gronkowski. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
Under 4 to go now as the clock runs, and they come up on second down. Again, they'll throw with Brady. And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete.
So much of this game is about leverage. We always talk about low man wins in the trenches. Well, it's like that of just about every position. And sometimes, if you lose that leverage and you're losing the battle, just jump up at the line of scrimmage and try and bat the ball away. And that's exactly what happened there.
Here we go, 3rd and 1. Gut check time on both sides. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. 56 yards for him on the ground now and 3 touchdowns to go along with it.
But they didn't accomplish their goal. They didn't get a stop there, gave up another first down. They have all 3 timeouts in their pocket. I think defensively, you've got to start thinking about using them here.
I was just going to ask you at what point you think now's the go time?
I think now's the go time. I don't think you sit back and wait because they can take a lot of time off the clock between plays and run 3 to 4 and really put you in a stressful spot.
So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. Brady. Throwing left side. He's got Gronk complete. And he'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6.
How about the timing on that one? Boy, they were in sync, weren't they? 3-step drop, balls out of his hands, right to the tight end. Nice completion, just like they do it in practice.
Clock continuing to run. They'll probably wind this all the way before snapping it on second down. A handoff, Fournette running left. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. Call that a loss of a yard, and things get a little more difficult here, 3rd and 5.
Now, obviously, that's some good work there defensively, being able to stop them and bring up a key 3rd down. But if you're on the offensive side of the ball, there's an opportunity, because I know what defensive guys are thinking right now, to stop them, get to the ball. That means they might not be sound defensively. There could be some opportunities.
And you said key 3rd down. Highlight that word. Put it in bold. Here we go. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes. And we've got a 1-score game. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. They're facing a critical 3rd down now as they try to hold on to this lead. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short.
Oh,
Here's a big one now. Trying to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Brady to throw for it on fourth down. And Brady, the tight end's got it. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. To Fournette, and he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. Now the Packers going to burn their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Again with Fournette, and he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. And now the question everyone's wondering, look at the clock, late fourth quarter, do they put the ball in the air here on third?
I don't. I run the football, and I tell my offensive line, no leakage up front. I don't want my running back hit as I hand the ball off to him. I don't want any type of an issue. But if I am going to throw, quick throw, to the perimeter, maybe one of my best receivers running a quick slant or something like that.
On third down, Fournette, and he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. 7 yards on the play, and that's going to bring up a fourth down.
This has been an up and down, back and forth type of a game, hasn't it? Maybe this long drive take a little bit of the wind out of their sails, kind of settle things down a little bit.
The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on fourth and inches. They'll go for it. It's Brady. And this is caught. It's pulled in by Gronkowski. And the Buccaneers are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feeling like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
For my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry, I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. And now we get to deal with a foot of snow in the parking lot as we say so long from Green Bay.
Love it here. This is Maui with snow.
That's one way to put it. So long, everybody.